Hi, friends. It's Mr. Sal. So, friends, now we are going to begin into our hand striking and volleying unit. Okay? We use hand striking and volleying in different sports and activities and exercises. For example, we use volleying in volleyball, of course. We use hand striking when we're doing, you know, boxing in the gym, you know, hitting a bag or hitting the, speed bag, or even in a real boxing match. We also do hand striking in different combat sports like martial arts and taekwondo, even taibo and kickboxing as exercise activities. And even with outdoor sports, we do games like gaga ball, which is a variation of dodgeball, where you actually have to hit a ball to tag someone instead of throwing the ball. Okay, so today's activity, friends, is called the Rocket. This game was created by Mr. Mike Morris of Open Phys Ed. I thought this was a very interesting activity because all you need is just a paper towel tube. That's all you need. So if you're learning from home, all you need is a paper towel tube. Ask mom or dad. If they can, give you one, all right? And make sure you save this too, all right? And then also, if we're in school, friends, don't worry. We can find paper towel tubes, for you as well, okay? So today, friends, what Mr. Sal is gonna show you is different ways to strike this paper towel tube to make it fly through the air like a rocket, okay? So let's just think about the definition of striking. Striking, friends, means to hit forcibly, okay? Forcibly means to hit hard, okay? So we're trying to hit something hard, okay? It's not a push where we're pressing something to, to make it go forward. Striking means to hit with force, okay? To make it go, make the object go forward, all right? So we're working on, in a sense, hitting. I'm not saying, work on hitting to hit people. No. I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying hitting objects to make them go forward, so it kind of, is the same as playing in a game of gaga ball or volleyball, to hit an object or a ball in different directions, all right? So that's what this game is called, the Rocket, all right? So our first skill, friends, all right, is called the Hammer. You're going to place your paper towel tube or your nail into your hand, okay? Make a C with your hand and then place the bottom of the rocket, okay? This is going to be called our rocket. Place your rocket inside your hand, holding it by the bottom. Do not squeeze it, because number one, you're going to break your break your rocket, and number two, if you squeeze it, you can't move the rocket, okay? So hold it gently. In a sense, have your hand hug gently, okay? Have your hand hug gently, okay? Our first challenge, friend, is called the Rocket, okay? Using your favorite hand. My favorite hand, right now is the right hand. All you're gonna do is just lightly use light force to just tap it, and watching the nail go through your hand, and then you're gonna tap it back up through your hand. So, friends, that's your first challenge. Every challenge, friends, we're gonna do for 30 seconds, all right? So, our first one is called the hammer. So for 30 seconds, you're going to hammer your nail down and hammer it back up. Okay, you ready?
Starting session.
All right, let's begin. Here we go.
Work.
The hand that is holding the nail, friends, does not move. Remember to hug your nail, don't squeeze it. We're tapping, which is a light force, friend, a light strike. Tap. Good.
Rest.
That was challenge number one, friends. Challenge number two is to put the paper towel tube in your other hand, okay? Your rocket in the other hand. Remember, make a C with your hand, place the bottom inside your hand, and then with your other hand, keep it nice and stiff, and just hammer it down through your hand. Okay, going down, and then going back up. Here we go, 30 seconds. Work on hammering your hand, you know, your nail down and up.
Work.
Good job. Okay, excellent job, friends. This was over our first two challenges. Our next challenge, friends, okay, you're going to now do the same challenge, okay, except you're going to be using a much stronger force, a much heavier force. So this time, make the C with your hand, place the rocket, you know, inside your hand. Friends, you are going to swing your arm up, and then swing it down to make the nail go down, all right? Let's give that a try.
Work.
Okay? Okay? That's okay. Try to hammer it down as best you can and hold the nail very lightly. I want you to keep your eyes on the rocket. Watch it go down. This is using a stronger force, a stronger strike. Okay, there you go. Now, challenge number four. Switch your hands now, friends, okay? Same thing, stronger force, hammer that nail down to the ground. Remember, make a C with your hand to hold. Place your nail inside your hand, hug it gently, and then use your other hand to strike it as hard as you can. If you have to hold it from the middle part, that's fine too, okay? Okay? Your swinging hand and your holding hand should meet, okay? Okay.
Rest.
Okay. So now we've done, okay, working on, you know, using a light force and a heavy force or strong force, okay? Now it's time, friends, to work on, excuse me a second.
Pausing session.
To work on making our rocket actually fly through the air, all right? So what you're going to do, friends, is you want to hold your, you know, actually, let me show you something. What you can do, friends, is you can draw a large line in the middle of your rocket because we're, you know, what you're going to do is hold the rocket along the line in the middle, okay? So friends, what we're going to do now is we're going to be practicing an underhand strike, like in volleyball, you know, the underhand serve, okay? And we're just going to track or watch the rocket go up and then go down. We're not going to catch it right now, okay? Because I want you to practice at home keeping your eyes on the rocket, okay? Because it's gonna be essential in our next challenges, which is gonna involve striking and then catching by yourself. Okay, are you ready? So watch this, all right? Hold it by the middle, okay? Hold your rocket in the middle, okay? Take your hand, swing it back, and then swing it up, and it should go flying up in the air. Now, I caught it that time, but watch this, okay? This is your challenge, is to strike and watch. Good. Just watch it go up and down. Okay, and that's your challenge. So let's try it out.
Starting session.
All right. Now if you're in a room that's very, you know, short, you know, the low ceiling, don't hit it too hard, but if you have a high ceiling like mine, try to hit it as high as you can, all right? No problem. Here we go. Ready? Just hit and watch.
Work.
Back, swing up, and hit.
Work.
job, everybody. Rest. Okay, whichever hand was holding your rocket, place it in the other hand, because now we'll be using the other hand to strike. Okay, so in this case, my left hand, you know, using this one to strike. We have to practice using both hands, all right? Because you know, you'll be a much better mover when you learn how to use both sides of your body. Okay, so 8 seconds, same thing. Hit and watch. Hit and watch. My eyes are glued to our rocket. Just watching the rocket go up and down. Keep your hand nice and firm, okay? Nice and flat, nice and firm. Hit and watch. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to be working on striking and catching now, friends. All right? Now, I know that catching something like this is a little awkward, okay? All right, because we're used to catching balls that, you know, that are easier to catch, or, you know, right? You know, they're not long, they're not, they're not long like this. So, your challenge, friends, is to catch using two hands, all right? You strike and catch with two hands, all right? For this one, friends, just keep your hands low, okay? Use a low catch, all right? Strike it up and use two hands and catch. Also remember, friends, when your rocket is flying through the air, try to move your body underneath to catch. You can't just plant your feet and then just expect the rocket to come back to you, okay? No, no, no. You want to move your feet and get under the rocket, okay? So it's easier to catch. Whoop. Okay, remember, hands ready, eyes watching, reach out, tuck in.
Starting session.
Okay, so now we're striking and catching with two hands. Okay, remember, keep your striking hand nice and firm, okay? And this hand does not move.
Work.
Strike it nice and hard. Okay, good.
Rest.
Our next challenge, friends, is to hit now with our left hand and catch it with two, okay? Now, friends, if your fingers are starting to hurt, okay, try hitting with your palm. Your palm is this part of your hand, okay? The big part right here. This is all your palm, all right? You can use your fingers to strike. It just might hurt after a while. So try to use your palm, okay? But that means keep your hand nice and flat and keep it nice and stiff, okay? Hard. Here we go. Left hand and catch with two.
Work.
Okay. If you're using your non-favorite hand, okay, this could be tough, but just do your best, friends, all right? Don't get frustrated if you don't catch it or don't strike it correctly. Good job, friends. You're doing such a great job. I'm so proud of everybody, okay? And above all, you should be proud of yourselves. All right. Now, friends, we are going to try to catch our rocket using an overhand catch, all right? So after you strike your rocket up in the air, reach up and grab it with two hands, okay? Keep your hands open and then close when the rocket touches your hands, like so. Overhand catch with two hands. Good job. Keep going. Remember, move your body underneath the rocket.
Rest.
Good job. We're almost done, friends. Okay, we're almost done. Now, place the rocket in your other hand, okay? Because we're going to strike with our non-dominant hand or our non-favorite hand, okay? Same thing, all right? Strike it up and catch overhanded with two hands, okay? Okay, remember, you have to reach for it and then close your hands and tuck it in. That's how we have good control, friends. Okay, here we go, 30 seconds. Take your time, friends. You don't have to rush this, okay? Yeah, this is all just for practice. If you want to count how many catches you get, you by all means, you can do that too. Good.
Rest.
All right, friends. Now we're trying to now we're gonna get into some more difficult challenges where we have to catch with one hand. Now, okay, with one hand. So this is a little bit more challenging. If you feel like you're not ready for a one-handed catch, stick with two. All right, but I'm gonna demonstrate how to catch with one hand. All right. So now we're gonna catch everything with the right hand first. Okay. Here we go. Strike it up. Catch with one hand. Okay.
Work.
You want to keep your eyes on the middle of your rocket, okay? Because that's the easiest place to catch. Okay, keep your eye on the middle of your rocket. And you can strike with any hand you want, but catch with the right. Okay. Now, I probably should have shown you this before, but our next challenge is to catch with the left hand. Try to keep your eyes looking at the line on your paper towel tube, okay? That's your target to catch at, okay? So, for example, I caught it, and my hand is on the line because I kept my eyes looking at my target, okay? Here we go. Catch the left hand. Great job.
Yes.
Okay, friends, here's our last challenge, okay? Now we're gonna be doing juggling hands, okay? Remember, juggling hands is when you're tossing and catching an object from one hand to the other. So same thing. You could strike the rocket with any hand you want, but you have to catch right hand, do it again, and then catch with the left hand, okay? So, right hand, left hand, right hand,
work.
Left hand. Right hand. Left hand. If it drops, friends, no big deal. Just pick it up and try again. Okay.
Rest.
So, friends, that is the game, the rocket. You could play back this video anytime you want to keep on practicing your striking and catching skills. All right? So, that's the game, the rocket. I hope you had fun, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.